Hereditary is the latest A24 art house indie film, and it stars Toni Collette as a mom of this pretty damaged family, and her mom just died, and now some weird stuff is happening to the family, and damaged relationships between the family are furthered, and people are pushed to the extreme. And that's really all I'm gonna give about this movie, because I feel like anything else are gonna go into spoiler territory, and I don't want to give away too much of this movie. But I was very interested about Hereditary, because coming out of Sundance, it had a fantastic trailer that I thought was chilling and kind of terrifying. And so I immediately want to see it, but I was a little bit skeptical because this is an A24 horror film and I saw It Comes at Night, so you can't fool me twice, A24. So trying to go into this movie with as much of an open mind as possible, and wow, this movie is heavy. One thing that I will say about this movie is that this is by no means a by-the-numbers typical horror movie, and I like that. I really like that about this movie, that it wasn't a generic jump-scare festive movie with horrible written characters and a plotline you can see coming from a mile away. Because granted, I had no idea where this movie was going at times, which I liked, and at times I didn't like, but I'll get into that later. But just almost everything in this movie is somehow horrific in some way or another, and is really unsettling. This is a really unsettling movie with the horror elements of it, and also just the humane elements of it. There are just certain character moments where a character may do something after a horrific event, and it may not be the right thing to do, but it's the thing that they do, and it is kind of scary what they do and how the movie presents it. Because this is Ari Aster's first film as director, and he does an amazing job. His style and his choices that he makes with either editing or the writing in this movie, he wrote this movie also, is amazing. There are certain moments where he chooses to focus on one thing or having a lasting character moment, as I said previously, that makes this movie rather unsettling and surprising. Toni Collette in this movie, she is unbelievable. A lot of this movie does carry on her back, and I can see how some people can be annoyed by how all she does is just cry a lot, but I think it's very appropriate because one, she doesn't just all cry, she does a lot of other things, but two, her character goes through so much in this movie, stuff that's happened in her past and stuff that's happening right now. And I can count so many times where she had an amazing scene, whether it's a monologue or doing just something crazy or insane, or when she has to break down crying. I thought she was fantastic, and I really hope that she is still focused on during Oscar season. One of the biggest surprises in this movie to me was Alex Wolff. That's right, Alex Wolff from the Naked Brothers Band. He's in this movie, he plays the older brother. He has a somewhat damaged relationship to his mom in this already weird family, and he plays a typical high school student, and he was fine for like the first maybe half hour of this movie, but after a certain incident that happens in this movie, he really pulls it in. There's a certain point in this movie, like right after this inciting accident that happens, where he has an amazing performance. I think it's a mix of his really great performance and a smart script that has some chilling ideas to it of what to do and what not to do in a situation and the way it plays out. Granted, there are some times when he has to cry in the movie, and whether he just has a really weird crying noise or he's just not a good crier, I guess he's not entirely amazing, but besides his crying stuff, I thought that he had a really great performance. I see as the one who's trying to deal with all the craziness happening in this family. The only ant character I would say is the dad. He's pretty much the, no, let's like not do all this weird stuff. Can't we just be normal? He's kind of underdeveloped and doesn't have that much to him, but didn't really bother me that much until I was analyzing this movie. But probably one of the bigger major setbacks of this movie is the pace and the fact that for nearly the entirety of the movie, it's pretty aimless. I really hate when movies do this, when there's no real goal or conflict in the movie and you're just seeing a bunch of characters do stuff. Granted, I can deal with this sometimes if it's done very well, but when you have a 2-hour long movie for almost the entirety of it where there's no real goal or the characters aren't trying to really aim or do something, it can get a little boring. Because for most of the movie, when there's a conflict or an idea that a character wants to do, the rest of the movie is them trying to achieve or fix the conflict. This movie is more of an event happens, character reactions, until an event happens, and then more character reactions, and it's just that in a cycle. You don't really know where the movie's going at times, which I said can be very good because it keeps the audience on their toes if you don't know what's gonna happen. But I felt for Hereditary kind of took it a little bit too far because the acting and the style in a movie can only take you so far, whereas an audience member, I have to say, why am I still sitting here watching this movie? I don't know what's gonna happen and I can leave right now and that'll be it. I wouldn't care. Because there's some times where you can just leave and like, you don't know what's gonna be ahead, so you have nothing really looking forward forward ahead. You just are in this 2-hour movie and you kind of just have to sit there and see what happens. Granted, in the end of the movie, you can kind of look back and see how everything plays to where the movie's going, but for a viewing experience, I feel like there are many times where the movie's just not that interesting to watch. But again, I still think that this is an amazingly crafted film. There's so many chilling aspects of this movie, especially due to its director, whether he wants to show something at the right time or linger on a creepy shot for an extended period of time, whether it's very present or hidden. The performances mostly around are amazing, but the movie does suffer from being pretty aimless at times. This is not a movie for everyone. It's definitely going to be controversial based on people's opinions, and while I would demote the movie for being pretty aimless and without conflict, this movie is so chilling with creepy style and imagery that I have to applaud it, and I can say that Hereditary is a great movie. So that's Hereditary. What do you guys think? Have you seen the movie? Have you not seen the movie? Whatever you think, put the comment below and maybe I'll read it. Maybe I won't. Thank you as always for watching, and if you haven't, you can click my last video right over here and you can click my upcoming video right over here. Thank you as always for watching and hope to see you next time.